Hello friends, in my this video, I am going to discuss the algorithm of perfect number, okay? That is not perfect number, perfect square basically. So, how to check whether an input number is perfect square or not? So, what is perfect square? Suppose 25. 25 is equal to 5 square, right? So, similarly 36 is 6 into 6. That is, if you, for a number, if you square, make it square root, then the root of a number should be one integer, then that number will be termed as perfect square, right? So, what is the algorithm to check whether a number is perfect square or not? And the algorithm is same for all the programming language, as I say, whether you are considering MATLAB or Java or C or C++ or Python, whatever. But the syntax will just differ. So, I will not only discuss the algorithm, I will show you the MATLAB code and as well as I will implement the same algorithm in Java also and I will show you how it works. Okay. Basically, algorithm is same only. So, step one is obviously to check whether a number is perfect square or not, you should square root it, right? Suppose I am giving you 25 as input. So, 25 first what you do, you take square root, you get 5. 5 is an integer, so that you say that, okay, 25 is a perfect square number, right? So, square root the number is step 1. Then, step 2 is, after square rooting, see 25, we are getting integer as 5. So, suppose the number is not a perfect number, then what you will get after making square root, you will get some decimal number, right? Decimal number means, suppose 26, 5 point something, after square rooting of 26, what you will get? 5 point some value. So, that is decimal number, not an integer number, right? Now, you have to check whether a number is decimal number or not. So, the easiest way to check whether a number is decimal number or not, is apply fill or round operation. Okay, in MATLAB and Java, for both the programming language, you can use library and you can get fill or round function. So what will happen? Fill will basically convert the decimal number corresponding to its next integer. Okay, next integer which is greater than that number. Suppose you are getting 5.001. So the next greater integer is 6, so it will convert into 6, right? So, round does, if the number is more than 0.5 of that number, then it will convert into next integer, and if it is lesser than 0.5 of that number, then it will convert into lower integer number. Like, suppose you take 5.001, it will convert into 5. Suppose it is 5.59, then it will convert into 6. Like that, the basic difference between fill and round operation, already I discussed in my previous video. If you want to check, you just go to the link. Okay? So basically, for an integer number, if you apply fill or round operation, you will get that number only, right? Suppose, let me show you in MATLAB. Suppose you are using this operator, fill of 5, you will get 5. Or round of 5, you will get 5. But, if the number is decimal number, then the round function value and the number value will not be same. So that's what we can do. We will apply fill or round function, then we will check whether that function output and the original number is same or not. If they are same, that means the number is integer. That means our original input number is perfect square, otherwise not a perfect square. Right. Simple algorithm, 3 steps. Make it clear concept. If you have doubt, you can ask in comment section. So, let me directly go to MATLAB and show you how to write the code. So, step 1 is x equal to input, then enter the number. Okay. So, first step is over. That is, enter the number and you have to square root this. So, y equal to sqrtx. Okay. Now, what you can do, you can store the seal or round operation in some other variable z equal to seal of y. Okay, I am using seal. Okay, if you want, you can use round also. So if z equal to y, then display yes, the number is perfect square number. Okay, So this is what? Or else display no, the number is not a perfect square number. Okay? And in this if else loop, control A, evaluate selection, enter the number, suppose let me give 25. Yes, the number is perfect number, you know that square root of 25 is 5. Now let us check for 26, and you know 26 is not a perfect square number. See, know the number is not a perfect square number. Suppose let me give input as 4. See, yes, the number is perfect square number because square root of 4 is 2 equal integer. Suppose let me give 5. See, no, the number is not a perfect square number. So our code is perfectly working. So I will post the same code in the description. If you want, you can check there. Now let me go to Java and let us check how to apply the same algorithm here. So first of all, in MATLAB, what we have done? We have taken the input and then square root it. So just do that. Okay. So to take input from the user, we use scanner class. So first import this scanner class. So import java.util.scanner. This is to import the scanner class. Then class, suppose let me give perfect. Then as usual we write public static void main string args is argument. Then create the object in the scanner class. So scanner obj equal to new scanner system dot in. Okay, then system dot out dot println enter the number. Okay, so in this way we have this code is equivalent to x equal to input the number in MATLAB. Okay, now you just store that in a variable. So what you can do, let me define first in m equal to obj dot next int. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to square root it, right? So for square root you have to import another file, that is import java dot lang dot math. Okay, so you can store in some other variable, and that may be double because that may be decimal value also. So double j equal to math dot sqrt. Squared spelling is same for MATLAB and Java. And then what is that number? M. Okay, now what you have to do, you can store in some other variable y equal to math dot fill of j. Then if y equal to z, then system dot out dot println yes, the number is perfect square number. Okay, else. Okay, so we have to close the bracket. In MATLAB, there is no concept of brackets. Anyway, now else system dot out dot println no number is not a perfect square number. Okay. Close the bracket for public static, close the bracket for class. So this is the code to write in Java. Also this, then perfect, then give the class name, perfect dot Java, save, then go to command prompt, cd Java, Java C perfect dot Java, is an error is coming, cannot find symbol Y. So here we have not defined, so int Y control S, because in MATLAB there is no concept of writing data type, but in Java you have to write that possible loss of precision. Okay, so required in found toggle. So what you can do, so here this kind of errors you can get, so you can make it double, because otherwise in Java it will show error. Although seed function will not give double, then Java perfect, click enter, enter the number. Suppose let me give 5. No, the number is not a perfect square number. Okay, let me check for other cases. Suppose let me give enter the number 25. Yes, the number is perfect square number. Let us check for other cases. Suppose let me give 45. No, the number is not a perfect number. Okay, so 49. See, yes, the number is perfect square number. So our Java code is also perfectly working. So now you just consider these two programs. See, the algorithm whatever we have applied is exactly same. What is difference? Just syntax. X equal to input enter the number. Here input java.util.scanner, creating scanner class, then scanner object equal to new scanner system.in, then enter the number, message will be shown in the comment prompt, int m equal to object.txt, just to enter the number. Y equal to square root of x. Here double j equal to math.square m. To do so, you have to import the math class. Then if j equal to y, first convert into seal, j equal to seal of y. Similarly, a double y equal to math dot seal of j. Then if y equal to j, comparison equals. They are here also equals. Okay. So in this way, this algorithm is same for all the programming language. Just syntax will differ. And I hope it is clear to you how to check whether a number is perfect square number or not, because lots of problems can be solved with the help of this algorithm. Just try to understand this. No need to memorize this. If you understand, you can write it easily. If you memorize, you may forget and you may do something wrong. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. And these two codes I will post in the description of this video. If you want, you can check there. Okay. Thank you for watching.